Want to give your viewers wishing powers? First things first, if you're here because you want to scratch your itch to wish, this is not it. You can do that on wishsimulator.app. Anyway, to use this, I still don't even know what to call this. You will need OBS and a Twitch account for streaming. Oh wait, you don't stream on Twitch? If you stream on YouTube, you can configure this using Sammy or StreamerBot. I have yet to make a tutorial on these things, so please stay tuned for those. Download the thing from GitHub. Link is provided in the description below, on the side, above, everywhere. Find a folder to extract it to, like the oh my god, not the desktop folder! You will end up with the following folders: CSS, fonts, image, JS, sounds, and the genshinwish.html file. The other files are just there so you don't sue me or, well, if you're bored. Go to OBS and add a browser source to your scene. You may enable the local file setting and point it to where the HTML file is, or you can open the HTML file in your favorite browser and copy the file URL to the URL field in OBS. Set the width and height to whatever size you prefer for your stream. That's it. If you know how to set up channel point redeems, or if you already have one, you can skip this part. Go to your creator dashboard, viewer rewards, channel points, manage rewards and challenges, and click on add new custom reward. Give it a name, remember this, and set the channel point cost. You can set the cooldown limits if you have a megaton of viewers, in case you don't want mega spam to avoid going mega toxic. Feel free to customize the other settings. Next, open the user settings JS file in the JS folder using whatever text editor. Yes, Notepad will do. Change the channel name variable to your channel name, or else you're going to have an awesomely spammy time when viewers spam this redeem on my stream when I'm alive. I mean, when I'm live. Remember the name of the channel point reward you created? Replace the redeem title variable with yours. That's it. To summarize, download, extract, add browser source in OBS, create channel point reward, edit the JavaScript file, and you're all set. Before attempting to customize this, I suggest you test it before anything. Anyway, the easiest thing to customize is the duration of the wish before it fades. You may change this by changing the animation duration variable in the user settings JS file. The default is 8,000 milliseconds or 8 seconds. If you want to change the pull rates, you can edit the rates.js file, or if you want to add or remove items, you can edit the choices.js file. Changing the pull rates is relatively easy. The numbers in the square brackets represent the star values, and the ones to the right of the equal signs are the rates or percentages. The default settings you'll see are 10% chance to pull a 5-star, 25% chance for a 4-star, and 65% to get a 3-star. If you just want to change the pull rates and keep the available star values, just change the numbers on the right. For example, if you want to increase the chances to get a 3-star, you can change this number to 85, but you will have to lower the other values to keep a total of 100. Like change the 4-star to 10 and the 5-star to 5. Please be careful to input only numbers and not the percent signs, and keep the semicolon right beside the numbers. If you wanted to add a chance to pull 1-star items, you'll also have to add a 2-star chance and add characters or items, which we'll tackle in a while. So let's say 55% for 1-star, 30% for 2-star, 10% for 3-star, 4% for 4-star, and 1% for 5-star. Again, for a total of 100%. Please note that this only accepts whole numbers. If you wanted to add 6-star and 7-star chances, you can also do that. Now that we're done with the rates, let's work on the characters or items. Looking at choices.js for the first time may seem daunting if you're not familiar with JavaScript, but that's what we're here for. If you are a JavaScript expert, Please don't forget to click that subscribe button on your way out for extra luck on your next wish. Again, the numbers inside the square brackets represent the star values. I set the 3-star as a dull blade meme, which we can customize later. If you added star values other than the default 3-star, 4-star, and 5-star ones, you'll need to add characters for them and their respective elements here. Add a character or item in the choices array variable by adding a new line, typing in the name in double quotes and adding a comma after. You will need to provide the images for anything you add in the characters folder inside the image folder. The file name needs to be exactly the same as how you put it in the choices variable. This script accepts WebP, PNG, and SVG images in this order of priority. Priority means that if you have a duplicate image of different file types like amber.webp and amber.png, this script will always use the WebP and ignore the PNG. You can then indicate this new character's element by scrolling down to the element dictionary function and adding a new line for the new character and follow the syntax. You can add elements which are not in the default list by specifying the element to the right of the character and then adding the image of that element to the image elements folder. If you think an application can be useful to edit these even more easily, please let me know in the comments or in my Discord so I know if it's worth spending time on it, since this script has a whopping 0 downloads as of now. You could also visit me on Twitch and complain there, live. If a GUI is already out by the time you're watching this, you could have skipped this entire section on customization, but that's like time traveling, which is definitely not gonna be possible yet, even if you're watching this in 2058 or something. If somehow this script has been updated with some mega features, I think you'll only need to overwrite the script.js file. Again, I can only assume that because I don't come from a future where, let's say, I already know that this script would have had the ability to change your life.